Today is November 17, 2020. Today is celebrated as the National Epilepsy Day. On this National Epilepsy Day, in the entire India, epilepsy awareness programs are conducted to educate the general public about epilepsy. So now, what is epilepsy? Epilepsy is a medical condition which affects the brain cells so that a person develops seizures or fits. Seizure or fits is the single event. So all the persons cannot be labeled as epileptic. When a person has two or more unprovoked seizures or fits, then only a person is labeled as epilepsy. So epilepsy is the most common chronic non-communicable disease of the world. So now coming to the prevalence of epilepsy. The prevalence of epilepsy in the entire world is 50 million populations are affected by epilepsy. Among that, around 10 to 15 million people are suffering from epilepsy in India. That means as compared to the entire world, 1/6 of the population of the epileptic patients are residing in India. So that is why the control of epilepsy in India is very important. Now next, why epilepsy occurs? There are certain causes for epilepsy. Everyone doesn't throw a seizure or fits. It can be either due to genetic makeup of the individual, second due to infections, third due to inflammation or any structural damage of the brain, either due to accident or due to tumor or due to stroke. So such patients can also develop seizures. So when there is structural lesion or secondary cause of seizure, it is completely treatable condition. And when genetic causes of seizures occur, the person need to be on medicines for a long period of time. Now, what is the problem in India? The problem in India is that majority of the patients with active epilepsy doesn't get proper treatment for epilepsy. That is, it has been noted that only 16% of the urban population and 10% of the rural population get proper treatment by an expert doctor, that is a neurophysician, neurosurgeon or an epileptologist or a medical practitioner who is trained in epilepsy. So it is, the problem is very high in India because 70% of the population doesn't get proper treatment. So why the problem occurs in India? The problem is either due to illiteracy, the person is unaware of the medical treatment available for epilepsy. Second is illiteracy. Third is the poverty. And fourth is the social stigma and certain cultural beliefs which are going in the society. That's why the person doesn't seek a medical attention. And the last is, even though the person reaches the doctor and get proper treatment, but they doesn't continue the medicine because of lack of availability of the medicine at the nearby area, or they doesn't have proper money to buy the medicine and continue the medicine regular. So this is the problem faced in India against epilepsy. Now coming to the myths about epilepsy. The myths are that certain myths are more common in the rural population than urban population. But a study in northern India shows that even the urban population have certain myths about epilepsy. So what is the myths? Myths. People think that epilepsy is not a medical condition. They think it is a supernatural activity or unnatural activity, and they have some superstitious beliefs about epilepsy. So instead of going to the expert doctor or a doctor who is trained in epilepsy, they seek the attention of local people or local magicians and certain babas, and they follow various rituals. And the epileptic person doesn't get proper treatment, and the epileptic person is made to suffer a lot, and they are socially discriminated from the society. And we need to break this myth about which is running in our society. Now, how to identify seizure? So how a person can identify seizure in a general population? So there are certain clinical features of seizures. That is sudden onset of loss of consciousness. Person will be sitting and suddenly patient will be unaware of the surrounding. Sometimes there won't be any unawareness from the surrounding. Person will have some involuntary movement of the upper limb. It can be tonic-clonic. It can affect one half of the body, that is right upper limb, right lower limb, or it can affect both the upper limbs, lower limb. Sometimes facial deviation will be there. Sometimes eye rolling will be there. Sometimes frothing from the mouth can be there. And when you call the person at that time, the person doesn't talk to you. He is unaware of the event. sometime after the event, and this event is episodic and it lasts for 5 to 10 minutes. And after the event, the person will be confused, or sometimes that person will have headache. Even it has been noticed that some person, during sleep also they develop seizure, and then early morning when they wake up, the relatives will see that the patient is having tongue bite. Such type of that type of seizure, real tongue bite, that bite will be occurring in the lateral part of the tongue. Sometimes the patient will urinate and pass motion in the bed. That are all the types of the clinical features of seizure one should identify. Sometimes suddenly a person is sitting and then talking, then he is not getting words. That is also a type of seizure. Sometimes suddenly a person has abnormal behavior and it lasts for few minutes. That is also a type of seizure. Sometimes another features are suddenly giddiness. Person will have giddiness and then sweating. It lasts for few minutes. All this episode most commonly will be associated with headache. So these are the clinical features how a common person can identify seizure. Now coming to the first aid. If you see a person with seizure, what you will do? If the roadside, so immediately you should make the person to lie in the prone and lateral position. Why we are doing? So that the secretion doesn't go through the trachea and the person won't aspirate. And immediately establish the airway, breathing of that person, and the person should be rushed to the nearby hospital. So it is always advisable that a patient with epilepsy should carry an identity card showing his name, his phone number, so that whoever unknown person see that person throwing seizure in the roadside, they can immediately intimate the family members. So this is the first aid should to be given to an epileptic patient. Now prevention. So if the person is already diagnosed with epilepsy, how we have to prevent the future seizure, because recurrent episode of seizure is not good for the health. This will cause cognitive impairment, that is memory impairment, and then daily activities of living will be affected, and the patient will be having disability in either in personal care or in his office work. So recurrent seizure is not good for a person. So how to prevent? That is regular intake of medicines. If your doctor has prescribed anti-epileptic drugs, it should be taken regularly by you and at regular interval. Without intimating the doctor, the medicine should not be stopped. Second, a person should not drink alcohol, or he should not do fasting, or he should not do sleep deprivation. So these are the four important factors to prevent seizure. Further, if a person develops fever, so you should know that he or she is having more chances of developing seizures when the fever is there. So properly medicine should be taken and immediately control of fever should be there. So these are the 4 to 5 methods to prevent seizure. And second, if you throw seizures, then at least it is better to avoid going in the lone places or drive bike or car by self for the at least for next 6 months, because there is 50% chances of throwing seizures even when you are on medicine, because this will harm the innocent people who are walking in the road. Next, coming the treatment. So what are the treatment modalities available? There are medical management is there, surgical management is there, and diet management is there. Medical management, your doctor will prescribe you the type of the anti-epileptic drugs. It can be according to the type of seizure, focal seizure or generalized seizure, you should follow that medicines. Second is the surgical treatment. There are certain surgery. If there is structural lesion, brain tumor or stroke or any structural lesion development abnormality is there, then surgery is indicated. The other indication of surgery is that if you are on medical treatment and two or more drugs in appropriate dose and appropriate interval and appropriate duration, then also you develop seizure, then it becomes a refractory epilepsy, then surgical option is considered by your doctor. And other treatment is ketogenic diet. Ketogenic diet is a diet where the person is avoid of increased carbohydrate diets. So ketogenic diet is the other modality of treatment for a person with refractory epilepsy. And one more modality is that vagus nerve stimulation also can be given for a treatment of epilepsy in refractory cases. Now I have discussed about the epilepsy prevalence, why epilepsy occurs, problems, how to identify. Because India being a developing country with 130 crore population, we know that one person of the population is affected with epilepsy. That means if we are thinking 132 crore population, we are having roughly 1.3 crore population is affected by epilepsy. So in conclusion, I want to tell that we should establish a balance between the belief and the science. Then only we can control epilepsy. I challenge epilepsy.